campaign finance system undermining American democracy. And that is why together we are going to overturn this disastrous Citizens United Supreme Court. The truth that if some people don't know intellectually, they surely know in their day-to-day lives, and that is we have a rigged economy. Today in America, the top 1/10 of 1%, 1/10 of 1% now owns almost as much wealth as the bottom 90%. 20 wealthiest people own more wealth than the bottom half of America, 150 million people. One family, the Walton family of Walmart, owns more wealth than the bottom 40% of family. I want to say a word, given that you already know the Walton family, I want to say a word about them. You know, you got a lot of Republicans, senators, governors going around the country talking about welfare abuse, poor people ripping off the welfare system. Let me tell you who the major recipient of welfare is in the United States today. It is the Walton family of Walmart. And you know why? They pay their workers at Walmart wages that are so low that many of their workers are forced to go on Medicaid, food stamps, and subsidized housing. And you know who pays for those food stamps, Medicaid, and subsidized housing? You do! That is what a rigged economy is, when the middle class has to bail out the wealthiest family in America. So I say to the Walton family, the wealthiest family in America, get off of welfare, pay your workers a living wage. But it's not just that we have a corrupt campaign finance system. It's not just that we have a rigged economy. And by the way, when we talk about the rigged economy, know this, that millions of Americans today are working two or three jobs. Mom works, dad works, the kids work, marriages suffer, kids don't get the attention they need. And after all of that, 58% of all new income goes to the top 1%. You ready for a radical idea? Not really so radical, but together we are going to create an economy that works for all of us, not just the 1%. And it's not just a corrupt campaign finance system and a rigged economy, it is a broken criminal justice system. What this campaign is about is thinking outside of the box, not allowing the media to define for you what you can think about. I want you to think about this for a moment. You are living in the wealthiest country today in the history of the world. Now, most people don't know that because almost all of the new income and wealth goes to the people on top, but that's the truth. What I want you to think about is how does it happen that in the wealthiest country in the history of the world, we have more people in jail than any other country on earth? China has a population four times our size. We've got more people in jail than China. What we are going to do is make profound reforms to end this type of nonsense where 2.2 million people in this country are rotting in jail right now, and we're spending $80 billion a year to keep them in jail. Just a few points on that. Just a few points. Today, when you look at unemployment, youth unemployment, if kids are white who graduated high school between 17 and 20, youth unemployment 33%. That's for white kids. Latino kids 36%, African American kids 51%. What we are going to do is invest for our young people in education and jobs, not jails and incarceration. We are tired of seeing videos on TV of unarmed people being killed by police officers. I was a mayor for 8 years. I worked with police departments in my city and all over this country. Most police officers work hard, are honest, and do a very, very difficult job. But if a police officer, like any other public official, breaks the law, that officer must be held accountable. We have got to demilitarize local police departments. We have got to make police departments look like the diversity of the communities they serve. In my state of Vermont, neighboring New Hampshire, and states all over New England and this country, we've got a major, major problem with heroin overdosing and opiate abuse. It is taking lives every single day. What we have got to recognize is that drug abuse, substance abuse, is a health issue, not a criminal issue. We have got to recognize that over the last 30 years, millions of Americans have received police records for the possession of marijuana. We need to rethink the so-called war on drugs. Right now, under the Federal Controlled Substance Act, at Schedule 1, the highest level, marijuana stands alongside of heroin. That is absurd. You can argue scientists are researching the pluses and minuses of marijuana, but everybody knows marijuana does not equate to the killer drug heroin. That is why I have introduced legislation to take marijuana out of the Federal Controlled Substance Act. Now, as you know, states have the right to legalize marijuana or not. That's a state issue. But I believe possession of marijuana should not be a federal crime. I want to I want to take a moment to talk about some of the differences between Secretary Clinton and myself. And those differences are pretty profound. And I'll give you some examples. Number one, you can tell a lot about a candidate based on how he or she raises the money they need for a campaign. When I began this campaign, we had no money, no political organization, nobody outside of Vermont knew who I was. Other than that, we were in pretty good shape. But what we had to do is make a decision. And the decision was, do we do what every other campaign does and establish a super PAC, go to Wall Street, go to corporate America, go to the billionaires, and beg for money? We agreed with what you said. No, we're not going to do that. Truth is, I don't now and I never have represented billionaires or the interest of Wall Street or the drug companies. We don't want their money. But what we did, which is something unprecedented, we said to the middle class and working families of this country that if you want to see real change in this country, if you want to see a candidate and a president take on the billionaire class and corporate America and Wall Street, help us out. And what happened is mind-blowing. Never in a million years would I have believed it could have happened. In the last 10 months, we have received over 5 million individual contributions.
In addition to that, as many of you know,
Secretary Clinton over the years has given speeches to Wall Street financial institutions behind